Hello, traders. It's time to look at one of my favorite indicators. It's the Ninjatrader Order Flow VWAP. All right. Now, their Order Flow VWAP is a VWAP indicator with deviation lines. All right. So sometimes they call these VWAP bands, VWAP standard deviations. Like you can find it on TradingView under VWAP STD because some of the people have made it. So it's not herpes. Don't worry about it. You can get rid of that indicator if you don't like it. But I'm just saying that this exists other places than Ninjatrader. But let's get into it. So you can see the chart here. This is a 2000 tick chart with the ES. And if you can see the red here in the middle, that is the actual VWAP line. So let's break this down a little bit. And then let's go back to the beginning over here to the left. You can see the VWAP line is green, and then it turns red, and then it's green, and then it's red. So with the Ninjatrader one, it goes green if price is above it. It goes red if price is below it. But I have kind of trouble seeing this stuff. I'm a little bit colorblind. And so the first thing we're going to do is go to the properties of this VWAP indicator. And we're going to go down to that red and green. We'll just make it a color I can see easily. I could have just made it all green. It's really the red that I have trouble with. But I don't have any need for that line to tell me if price is above or below it. I can see that. So just one solid line, I think, works better. If you want to make that lime green, maybe you can do that. But so that was one option. Now, the other thing I want to show you here, and then we're going to get into, after I show you some of these little details, we're going to get into how to use it in trading. So stick with me here a little bit. So if we come over here to the right in the settings on the VWAP, you know, you've got interval session. So you can set the VWAP to just the session. You can set it for the week. You can set it for the month. And that's going to dramatically change the way that looks. So real quick, let's just set it to the week. We'll see how that changes things. And now all of a sudden you can see that for the week, price was within these deviation lines because the week is taking into account all those days, right? And so it's saying, hey, price, at least on February 6th, was staying within these top two deviation lines. So here's the VWAP down here. And then that's one deviation, two deviations. And then here's a slight little preview. It comes up and hits this second deviation away from VWAP. And then that's when price starts tracking back. It starts tracking back to the other deviation line. It seems to do this. So that's why I've kind of replaced trend lines. I fell out of love with trend lines quite some time ago and then found this VWAP, and I just like it much better. We're going to go down to this. We're going to change this to lime. We need to be smarter about this. All right, so now you can see clearly where the VWAP is. All right, so that's the week long. Obviously, if you change it to the month long, the VWAP lines are going to get even more spaced out because there's going to be that much more price it's got to account for. So for now, let's just go to session. That's typically all I ever use it on is session. Let's get our price chart back up here. So that's one of the settings. Let's go back and let's dig in a little bit more. So resolution, I am using a tick chart. So if you're not using a tick chart, just use standard. But if you're using a tick chart, change the resolution to tick. I'm not sure why. That's just the way it works at Ninjatrader. It makes sure that you get the most accurate information possible if you change that resolution over to tick if you're using a tick chart. And then you can change the deviation areas so we could change the colors of the deviation area. So deviation one could be a color, deviation two could be a different color, and so on and so forth. I just leave it all on the default setting of corn flower blue with that little bit of opacity back there. I don't need different colored ones. It's fine with me. And they separate them by default by opacity. So you can see that within the first deviations of the VWAP line, or the volume weighted average price, it's darker, and then the opacity gets a little bit more clear as you go out. Now, the other thing you can do is where is it? I'm almost positive that you can eliminate the deviations. Aha, here it is. So from three, you can change it. If all you want is a traditional volume weighted average price line, you can change this to none. And then naturally, wait for it to calculate. Now all you've got is the VWAP line. All right, the boring stuff is done. That's pretty much all the settings for the most part. You can change it one, two, three, depending on the deviations. I always leave it on three. So that's pretty much all you got to know about that. Now let's get into how to use this to your advantage. Like I said, if you're familiar with trend lines, basically what you're doing with a trend line is you're kind of measuring the volatility. And so you're saying, you know, price has been coming back this much and hitting this area over and over, you know, as it goes up diagonal or a range or whatever you're drawing the trend lines for. So this is kind of the same way. So you're finding out just how far away from the average price does price get on the day. So if we come back to February 6th, you can see at the beginning, you know, in the overnight hours, it's kind of going back and forth over this VWAP line. And then it breaks through the first standard deviation, but it comes down and it touches that second deviation line. Comes all the way back up to the VWAP, and this is the classic VWAP play. Is price comes back to the VWAP, bounces off, gives you a signal to go short. That's like the classic way to use VWAP. And so it comes off of that, and it breaks through that first deviation line, the first standard one, but it doesn't go very far, and then it's kind of creeping back into that deviation, and it just gets stuck in there for the rest of the day. It was kind of a slow day on that one. But as you can see, you knew from the previous one that price hadn't, for at least at this point in time, made it far enough away from price to break a second deviation. So honestly, if I had gone short, and this is the strategy here, if I had gone short at this VWAP, my first target might be the first standard deviation, and then my second target might be the second standard deviation. And that may be arbitrary, but you need some sort of targeting system, and you need some way to make sure that you're holding trades long enough to get that positive risk and reward, so you're not just bailing out of trades way too early all the time. And likewise, when it couldn't get to the second deviation, it starts creeping back up in this one. On this pullback, you know, I would like to see it hit that deviation line and reject, and maybe that's where I would take it along to try to get up to the top over to the other side. To that other deviation again. And now this day plays out a little better on that. So this is February 7th. So at 7:32, you can see from, if you go to the overnight stuff, you know, broke through the first deviation a little bit and then came right back. We come down, we come all the way down to the third deviation, but we come up, we break right through that VWAP line, but it stalls out at the first deviation, okay? And so it's just helpful to be able to look for, well, I know it's at least, price is at least one deviation away from the volume weighted average price, so that should give me somewhat of enough room to take a stab at it. And now your choice is, do you want to take your target at a deviation, the first deviation, or do you want to try to go all the way down to where it's been tracking before? And so what you'll notice back here at 5 o'clock is we barely broke that second deviation. We almost made it to the third, but we kind of barely broke that second one. And then lo and behold, when it comes back later, it makes it back into that second one again, breaks it just a little bit again, and then can't make it any further, right? And then when it comes up and goes through the VWAP, it comes up to where? The same place that it had been diving before, first deviation, It did touched once and twice and three times. So it doesn't have enough oomph on this day. And then it comes back and touches it again and goes down. So that's just, it's just a good measurement to know just how far the volatility of price can move on a given day at a given moment. Now you'll have certain days where it's just junk. Of course, nothing always works all the time. And it never really touches any lines. It just kind of floats around in there. And those days, it's not going to be any good for you. But I love this indicator. It helps me visualize. Like, I don't blindly just take trades off a deviation line or whatever. But it really helps me visualize how far price can move. And it helps me. The main thing it helps me with is not really entries. The main thing it helps me with is going for bigger targets. So that's been what I've been working on lately, is hitting bigger targets, getting that risk to reward to be better, you know, instead of like a 1-to-1, I want to go for like 1-to-3, you know, I want my winners to be 3 times what my losers are. And without some sort of measurement on the table, you're never going to do that. You're psychologically going to bail yourself out. But if you know that there's a good chance I can get all the way to this other line, even if it's only in your head, what it does is psychologically allows you to hold on to the price without bailing out at 4 ticks or something like that, you know, and then all of a sudden you're lopsided on your risk to reward. So that's my rant on that. It's a very simple little, you know, it's you can totally visualize it. It's a very simple indicator, and it's one that I actually use every day, and it's been a great help. So that's that. I'm going to put my face up in the left-hand corners, hit that button, hit my face, smash it, punch it, scrape it, I don't care, cut it, but whatever you do, subscribe. That's what that face is there for, is to subscribe to the channel. And then down to the right, you'll have another one of my videos to click on. We got to keep this ball rolling, boys. Thanks. I'm out.